Hello Dan, it's Joe here. I'm writing you this email. It was the 24th of December when they let me out of jail. I got out on good behavior with a peaceful life to lead. But what I saw you do on Christmas Day, I just couldn't quite believe.
I'm not gonna lie, Dan, you let me down this Christmas. There's only one thing I wanted, and that was gravy.
I made it pretty clear that I love gravy. I talk about it all the time. The guys in prison, they say, hey, shut up about gravy, mate. And so I'd shiv them in the spine,
and then I'd keep talking about it.
When I saw you making gravy,
to be honest, Dan,
I kinda went straight insane. Look, I've always told you, just add flour, salt, a little red wine. I said tomato sauce for that extra tang and sweetness. It's a simple recipe. But then you put in soy sauce. Oh, what the fuck is wrong with you? And I could taste some cinnamon. Who puts cinnamon in gravy? I mean, sure, I went to jail, but you're much, much worse. I saw Stella put chocolate in it. She's the one who should be arrested.
Calm down, Joe, mate. You're doing all right. Just relax. Do your breathing.
I didn't say put mustard into the fucking gravy. Stop being avant-garde with gravy. You're not Gordon fucking Ramsay, Dan. Now I'm back in jail, and all the prisoners are scared of me, because I scream in my sleep at night. That's not how you make gravy. I'll stab you, I'll stab you. I'm sorry, I stabbed Roger and got sent back to jail. Now I make gravy in a toilet, but stabbing Roger was worth it. And next time I see you, just make the fucking gravy. Don't try and get fancy, and you better remember this. When I get out next Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Dan.